Okay, so in the last class, about how or what are the different methods by which or techniques by through which we could get the evaluation or for formations which we are dealing with as a reservoir. Okay, so we are discussed during the mud logging. Okay, we do logging while drilling information also to get our formations evaluated. Then we collect whole core samples, even sidewall core samples, to get the informations. Then we wear line logs, then case toll case we also did. And then we are now discussing the topic which are important for understanding the dynamics around the reservoir during the flow. Okay, so that we have discussed. Now if you just see the next slides, it will be very easy for understanding the dynamics. Even initial part, we just capture the dynamic information through the well tests, transient well tests, and follow-up action. Even throughout the reservoir exploitation, we just analyze the reservoir by receiving or by acquiring the information related to well testing. So different types of well tests we have discussed. So last class also we have understood very. This is what in different scale we gather information. I discussed this one also in the last class. Okay, so now this is the well site. Okay, just a picture of well site with a lot of things are there. So maybe in the early stage of our transient well testing, we may have to go to the drill site when the drill rig is still there and we need to conduct our study. Okay, so this is what we need to carry out our study. This figure also give you some idea. So what we need to carry a bottom hole winch van. Along with that, we have the winch, where we have the wear through which we lower down our instrument up to the desired depth. And this study, you see the electronic memory gauge through the cable. Okay, so this is what the setup is. So today we'll try to understand how we do, what are the different tests we perform or perform. And then we'll try to just get little bit idea of what are the basic philosophy or science behind, science and mathematics behind this. Okay, so this is clear to you, everybody. Last class we have discussed in detail. Maybe two class I have same topic. Okay, so this is what we discussed. Okay, so now you see where we are lowering down instruments. If you see the figure, particularly the left side and right side, the downhole figure particularly, you see the bottom hole pressure gauge in the left side also, it is there. Okay, and in right side also you have the bottom hole pressure gauge. Okay, so that means we need to lower down our instrument up to the desired depth. And what is the desired depth? It is above the perforation depth, isn't it? I told you earlier also. So this is what the configuration. So try to understand and visualize what we do right from the surface to subsurface, how long or how what depth we reach or send our instruments. Okay, so now what is a well test? A tool for reservoir character evaluation and characterization. So what it is a flow experiment actually. So what input is our production or injection flow rate? That means either we are allowing a well to flow, or a flowing well we are closing it, or we are injecting certain amount of fluid in injection well. And then what in the well it is interacting with the fluids there, and then we are getting certain parameters which is actually bottom hole pressure. So as we discussed earlier, we are lowering down our instruments up to certain depth. We are keeping it for some time. Okay, some time means it may be days, it may be hours. That is basically the philosophy behind our study. What the purpose we are doing, we'll discuss one by one. Okay, so investigates a much larger volume of the reservoir that cores and logs did or do. Okay, so could you get the idea? We discussed earlier the scale. Okay, please don't annotate. Okay, so stop recording. Pressure. Okay, so whenever we are getting the information, then what we discuss in different scale, we gather information regarding our well. So if you see, in case of our simple rock chips, or maybe the core, or maybe the well log, we get information up to a different scale. But here, well test actually gives you a lot more or larger volume of information. Okay, so that is what it is happening. Okay. So then the provides estimates of permeability under in situ conditions. I will discuss that part. So basically, we require certain required to understand certain information. Provide estimates of near river conditions. We discussed about what wellbore storage effect, skin effect. What is the skin? It may be a positive skin, it may be a negative skin, and also provide the distance to the boundaries, or maybe if you have a drive support or not. So everything we could get through the well test. Okay. So this is what we allow. So now what is a test? Okay. So if you see here, so you can see a well test is conducted like this. You see your instrument here, the picture is slightly wrong actually. If you see here, this is actually it is against the perforation, but most of the cases we keep our instruments above the perforation. Okay, so once we allow it to, so you can see it is a flow experiment that we carry out in a reservoir. Okay, in a well testing, we flow a well at a constant rate or pressure. So what you have two parameters, one is Q, another is P. Okay, so either you can keep the flow rate constant or we can keep our constant pressure, but flow rate sometimes cannot be maintained. So that's why sometimes so different way we conduct it, measure the pressure changes or rate as a function of time. So what if you allow a well to flow for constant rate, sometimes what happened, it will be supported initially through the well, then it would be supported from the your reservoir slowly. So initially you will be clearing from the well bore. Okay, that means the fluids which are stored into your well bore, or you can see the string, production string, then the flow will pass to your particularly your sand face or the perforation, then the flow should be moved towards your reservoir, common reservoir. So that is how it is happening. So what we are trying to get the informations, okay, most common one is the flow in constant rate or pressure. Okay, so what we gather from it, so why we need it for knowledge of formation property, so around the wellbore. So as a geoscientist, you must know what are the parameters, or what are the parameters actually affected during the flow and how we gather the information. Okay, so this is actually a dynamic test. Then for optimizing completion, you see right side is written reservoir development. So that means when we are trying to develop our field, we should understand what are the parameters we require and how we get the parameters right. Then we see optimizing depletion plan. That means when we are exploiting a reservoir, we must know at what rate we should produce from a well or from the reservoir. So that is now we need to follow our part. Okay, so then these are just a idea. We have discussed about our contour mapping. So if you see, our contour mapping is there. Okay, so once you see a contour mapping, so you can understand the subsurface feature and you have a different well location. So what we can test, a single well test, we could do the multi well test, and to understand how they are connected to the nearby well, or maybe how the well or around the well bore are changing, or what the well bore the formations are. Okay, so it is not only just understanding the well bore storage effects, skin, or maybe the, you can get the idea about the boundary, at what distance the boundary is located, in which direction is boundary located, if you have fault or not, or maybe your heterogeneity around the well bore. Okay, so now you may have a different types of well test. This is a single well, you may have a multi well. And if you see, when we are allowing a well to flow, you can see with time your propagation, or the that means the affected area will increase. Okay, and that's why once we do our study, your affected area will move. I will discuss this in subsequent classes. This is called compressible zone. What it is, it is like just like once you were dropping a stone in a pond in a water, so you see the ripple will move. So that means the ripple and the before and after the ripple wave, you don't have anything that is plain more or less. So the same way we just try to understand with time how the pressure pulses or the fluid column is moving with the pressure pulses, and that gives us the information about the physical nature of the well. So are you getting this idea? So this is what we are trying to understand, the physical nature of the wellbore as well as the wellbore surrounding up to the boundary, the how the propagation of the flow is moving towards the well or the pressure pulse is moving, and that indirectly gives you the physical nature, or you can say the geology of the rocks, formations or reservoir. Okay, so that is how we are trying to understand. Okay, from here our reservoir. So now you see here the what, why we need it for knowledge of formation properties, reservoir depletion, for optimization completion, reservoir development and reservoir management. So if you see the right side points, every bit of parameters you could get it from the reservoir test or maybe the transient well test. So reservoir pressure, transmissibility, permeability, wellbore damage, radius of drainage, reservoir heterogeneity, reservoir continuity, success of workover jobs, effect of pressure maintenance, fluid type. Okay. So now with an advanced well test study, people can get each and every information in dynamic form. So what is the, so now if you just try to visualize your idea, we have our information regarding the fluid type from the PVT study and sample collected by different way, number one. Second, we try to understand the petrophysics of the rocks, of the reservoir rocks, by understanding the core plug or by doing some core flooding apparatus study. Okay, porosity, permeability, relative permeability, saturation, capillary pressure. Okay, so this is all in static condition except permeability. Then we try to get certain all the information, saturation values, then your permeability or sometimes also, and the rock texture also, mineralogy also through the well log. Okay, so this is all in the static condition in most of the cases and not in the reservoir pressure temperature condition in many times. Okay, so now here what we get? We get the in situ information from the well away from and the six subsequent sections of the reservoir, and that is very important for understanding the reservoir dynamics. Okay, so once you just see this is this important information, then actually you could sum up. Okay, so now just what I'll just again trying to give you some idea. So now see, surface part is very much clear to you from the last class. Now subsurface, we are lowering down our instruments up to this. Okay, so up to above the perforation. So what we are doing? Either a single test we are performing certain study, or we are using multi-well. Multi-well means one well is called active well and the away well is called the observation well. We are allowing an active well either to close or to produce more, and we see how the pressure pulses is reaching to the or affecting the other wells production or the observation well values. Okay, so this is how we conduct the test and try to understand the communication between a well, or maybe the injectivity of a well, or maybe the permeability around a well bore, or their directional permeability. Let's say a well having a eastern side good connectivity or permeability, but western side it is not good. So that means each and every information we could gather right from the well test, either in a single well test or maybe from the multiple well test. Multiple means in conjunction with other wells. So one well where we are doing the test, that is called active well, and another well where we are observing the values or the parameters, that is called the observation well. Okay. So well test is a flow experiment that we carry out in the reservoir. In a well testing, we flow a well at a constant rate or pressure and measure the pressure changes or rate as a function of time. Most common one flow is flow in constant rate and measure the pressure, because, and this is the sometimes a problem also, you cannot get the constant rate because the value is always fluctuating. So that is how there is a problem with doing experiments sometimes. Okay, so then if you just see this, so objective of well testing: obtain information about the reservoir well system. So if you are doing for a single well, what we gather for well information? That means what is the wellbore storage effect? Wellbore storage means what is the type of fluid there inside the well when we are cleaning the well or when we are producing the well? Is it a gas Is it a oil? Is it a heavy oil? So that information we could gather from the pressure value itself. Then second is, let's say, a wellbore surrounding. Wellbore surrounding means just from the flow pattern or the pressure behavior, we can understand, is it a fractured well around the wellbore? Is it a restricted flow? Or we have all sorts of information we could gather just observing the pressure behavior of the early time. So we have three different time zone actually. One is called early time response, then we have middle time response, then we have the late time response. Generally, the early time response related to the wellbore storage effect. Wellbore storage effect means it's just a tank. Let's say wellbore, the production pipe or production string is a container tank where we are taking out the either oil or gas. So that means it will always give you an information. But when it is going, that means what is happening? When we are taking out the material from that means oil or gas or maybe whatever material, so that actually give us some pressure value because the well memory gauge is below. So as you are cleaning the above head of the fluid column, so obviously your pressure will decrease and that will follow a straight line value in case of pressure versus time. Okay. Then it will deviate from that. Deviate from that means by that time you are clearing your string amount, it will actually what? It will allow the sand phase to enter the reservoir fluid inside the well. So that means we have we'll see the graph afterwards, not now, maybe after the next classes. So that information is very important to understand what is happening around the wellbore. Is my well or maybe the skin is there or skin is not there? Is it a stimulated well or it is a restricted permeability around the wellbore? So every information you could just observing the well or the pressure versus time graph, we can easily understand. Okay. So particularly reservoir informations about factors, parameters, which help us to reservoir description. So now initially I talked to you about three different time domain. One is early time. Early time is affected by the generally by the wellbore storage effect and the skin, because you know about what is skin. During the drilling time, maybe it is not only drilling time. We have a lot of skins that also one class will discuss. So skin means not only the restricted flow. Okay, it may be the choke perforation, it may be due to some deposition on the perforation, it may be due to partial penetration, it may be due to geometric effect, means we have pay thickness more, but the perforation interval is less. So for different way, or maybe a deviated well. So different way you may get a skin, okay? So once you complete or the flow or the compressible zone passes away or away from the skin, then we have our normal reservoir behavior. Normal reservoir behavior means the actual homogeneous or heterogeneous reservoir. That also give us certain information. So that will give us the particularly reservoir system. The reservoir system means, is it a homogeneous reservoir? Is it an infinitely acting reservoir? Or it is a fractured reservoir? Or it is a channel reservoir? Every reservoir has a specific pattern of flow behavior, and that we could gauge it from the pressure value or pressure response. Okay. So this is what is happening. Sometimes we get straight line behavior, sometimes we don't get the straight line behavior. So that is how each and every time we are getting certain information. Okay. So that means what is happening with time, we have started getting our information initially related to well, then around the wellbore surrounding, then the pressure pulses move away from the well, so we are entering into the reservoir domain. So middle time region is responsive or giving us the information regarding the middle time region. Then what happened, we discussed about the aquifer system or the drive system. If your drive system is there, that means after your end of your reservoir system, you are entering into the support from your drive mechanism or maybe some sort of support or no flow boundary. So that also change your pressure. So this is what is happening in the whole flow system. And we, from the pressure study, we could gauge the physical nature of the reservoir in terms of storativity and transmissivity. Okay, two terms we will get. So that part we'll discuss when we'll discuss a little bit of mathematical equations, or maybe you can say diffusivity equation and their solutions. Okay. So next is we have different types of well. So far you learned. One is exploratory well, another is delineation well, then we have a development well. We may have a different category wells we are drilling in different times. So exploratory well means it's a very early well. Okay. So that means we test for different purpose. What are the purpose? Porous zone identification and logs with respect to hydrocarbon. Okay. So if you remember your HP log or maybe the resistivity log, you can understand which zone is porous and permeable, isn't it? So that means whatever response we got from a log response, is it valid or not? Is it permeable or not? So by testing this transient well testing data, we could gauge it. To measure the initial pressure, generally each and every formulations of the reservoir engineers are with the PI, initial pressure. So to get the initial pressure, I discussed in the last class also, once we clean the well, then we allow the well to flow for some time, then close it and get the static bottom hole pressure. So very first measurement of the static bottom hole pressure, if the well is connected very nicely to the your well bore, so that time we get the pressure, which is called initial pressure or PI or maybe the very early pressure, okay, PI. Rough estimate of reservoir permeability. So that we'll discuss slowly. When we are getting out of the skin effect, so we got the general reservoir sequence means normal reservoir. So just by analyzing mathematically, we got certain values, permeability, reservoir permeability, which is in situ permeability. Now you learn how we collect the permeability value by core plug study. Okay, so the core plug or maybe, so that information you could match with your reservoir permeability, in situ reservoir permeability. So that is now how you have to work in future. It is not only one information. By collecting different informations, we have to go ahead for our understanding. It is not a single data which will support you. Okay. So now objective of well testing for delineation well. To test potential zone which has been identified on exploratory well. So what if you have identified an exploratory well, you are now come up with a delineation well. That means is this well is connected very much to the exploratory well which you drill far away maybe from this well. Or whatever the permeable zone we have identified there, now we may test it for understanding the particularly potentiality or maybe the commerciality of that specific zone. Or if we have a multiple zone of your reservoir, then we can test specific well for contributing which zone will complete first for the production. Okay, so that is how we do. Evaluate their thickness and depth and locate fluid contacts. To generate PVT data also, sometimes we do some tests to understand the compressible nature of the fluid. Investigate aerial extension of producer in the vicinity of the well. So that means radius of investigation. If you go back or visualize your the diagram which I have shown you, just like so you can understand with time your zone of effect will increase because your propagation of the pressure pulses will move out away from your well. So that gives you understanding how long or how big this reservoir is, what is its boundary, okay, what is the so by understanding this we can extend our reservoir or reservoir boundary for the delineation well. So that means initial exploratory well we do some for a specific purpose, then we do certain well tests in the delineation well, then we do something in development well. What is development well? You know that is what we are discussing now. Development well means when we have delineated our reservoir, we have estimated our reserves. Now we are planning for exploiting efficiently from the reservoir. So now we are drilling wells which are in the proved zone. And this drilling is done for exploiting efficiently from the reservoir resource or reserves. Okay. So that is how these development wells are specifically done. And we also plan for testing. So what are the objectives? To measure formation damage around the well bore. That is skin. That means really during drilling time, have we damaged the reservoir or maybe have we damaged the well bore surrounding? So what sort of stimulation job we have to do? Is it, or if it is a tight reservoir, should we require stimulation job or the particular the fracturing job to be done in this well? So this is what we are doing, okay? To know whether damage has been removed by stimulation job or not, if removed efficiency. So you heard about workover job. Workover job means the, let's say the well facing certain sort of problem. So now we do certain job to overcome the problem and try to see the well is producing its optimum efficiency or not. Okay, so that's why whether this damage. So if we do some stimulation job or activation job, then before the stimulation job, we have some parameters. Then after the job, we do the test to understand whatever job we have done, is has it worked out properly? The efficiency has been increased or not, so that we can also understand. To know the exact KH value of the producing zone in that well, and if necessary, run selective test to sublayers in banded reservoir. So this what we have different types of flow actually. Okay, so now each and every pressure pulses actually now in the advanced well test analysis, people are trying to match with the polynomial. Okay, and trying to get what sort of flow is there. Is it, that means each and every details could be found out by the well testing if you've done it properly. Okay, so is it a banded layers or the layers having different permeability, or if you have a fault very nearby, if you have sealing fault, non-sealing fault, channel. So everything could be done with your diagnostic plot. Okay, so now to monitor reservoir pressure, run pressure buildup test periodically in few selective wells and analyze pressure response. So I told you how this behavior of pressure and production is going on with time. Because what, as an engineer, our role is to exploit efficiency from this specific reservoir. So what we do actually, we try to understand properly how the behavior is going on. Is it any drive support is there? If you remember our plotting of particularly the material balance equations, okay, the graph we have plotted it for different purposes, isn't it? Sometimes to understand the effect of drives, water drive is there or not, it is a depletion drive. Okay, so everything. So that means what, in which pathway it is following. So that plotting graph, plotted graphs can give you some idea for how to go beyond your go for your development activity. So that means it is a combination of effect, not only a single value. So that's why whenever we are exploiting a reservoir or a well, each and every time we try to record the pressure as well as production simultaneously. What are the oil, gas and water production? So that you, each and every year, dynamic analysis you have to do, how things are changing with each and every year. Then we need to plan for subsequent activity. If you remember, we discussed about planning in the early stage, planning in the initial stage, mature stage and the end stage. So each and every time we are added up with new information, further information, which actually give us the more detailed information about the reservoir performance and behavior. Okay, to test vertical communication into producing zone. So you could understand, is there any communication between two zones which are producing or perforated? So that is the to monitor the pressure maintenance. If you are injecting, let's say we discussed for secondary, sometimes we inject water in the aquifer and gas in the gas cap. Okay, so is the pressure is properly maintaining? Is it distributed throughout the reservoir, or it is going in a selective area and pressure is maintaining a certain part, not the throughout the reservoir? So that also you could do. Okay, and if your water is going somewhere, it is not going to your proper reservoir, or it is not supporting your reservoir pressure, that means it is going somewhere else. Okay, so that's why it's very important to understand all the things together. Okay, so now just if I just give you the diagram, it will give you a clear idea. Okay, so let's say this one. So if you just see the right figure, okay, right side figure. So what we are doing, a drawdown test, start of a drawdown. Then number two is expansion of the compressible fluid in wellbore annulus. So what is happening? Once you do, when allow it to clean clear through the drawdown test, that means you are producing at a specific rate. So initially, the flow should be from the wellbore only. Okay, so that is affected in your pressure. If you go below, you can see the pressure is immediately from the first is one, start of drawdown, then second is expansion of the compressible fluid in wellbore and annulus. Okay, then third one is skin. Surrounding the wellbore, you may have a skin, which is the below figure, which is the, you can see the gray in color. So if you see, there is three lines in the gray color area. One is solid line, which is if you don't have any skin, you will get your pressure decrease the same path. Okay, if you are stimulated the well, then your pressure will be not following the path but the dotted line. Negative skin, that means you have stimulated this available surrounding. If your pressure is decreasing, the rate which is decreasing here more, then it is positive skin. That means if you have a restricted flow here, that means you will get certain pressure changes in your recording, because that part is not supporting your flow. So what, because you see, we are started the drawdown at a specific rate, but that rate is not supported by that area. That means the storativity as well as the transmissivity of the skin is not supported for your Q. That's why you know the in Darcy equation, Q is proportional to del P, isn't it? Pressure difference. So that's why if your the Q is not supported properly, so your pressure will drop. That means pressure will fall. So the simple method we utilize to understand how much it could store and how much it could supply. Okay. So initially, so you can see the time region of pressure transient, wellbore storage effect, it is early time phenomena, damage or stimulation effect near the wellbore, that is also early time phenomena. Then once your compressible zone, okay, moved away from your skin, you see this is the normal reservoir situation, okay? That means that time it is called average reservoir KH. So if the reservoir is homogeneous, that time the pressure is not reached to the boundary, so we can call it an infinitely acting reservoir. That means if it is not affected by any boundary sort of things, you will get a constant support of your Q, and it appears to you the reservoir is infinitely extended. Okay. Now in the next, when it is reaching to your boundary, that means you may have support, you may not have support, or you have a constant support. So that's why you will get some graph which are actually you will get the boundary effect. So this is what in the time region it is considered, and what it is here, the boundary effect. So this boundary may be circular, may be elliptical, may be different types. So that we'll try to understand a bit during our course of study. Okay. So that will give you, so if you have a support, it may have a support, it may not have a support. Okay. So depending on the support system, automatically if you are not getting any support, your pressure will decrease, and that will be affected in your pressure response in your recording instrument. So that's why right from the beginning to the end, what is happening actually, you can see like this graph. Okay, if you see the first graph, which is actually a semi-log plot. Okay, if you are plotting a semi-log plot, you see that we discussed about time from here to here. Okay, so this is what is right from here, we are getting certain information. Okay, so what is happening? It is happening here. So initial part, you are getting up to this. So this is your, you see early time response, transition region, and this is in, so up to this, you are getting a disturbance, which is related to the early time zone. Then in the same case here, you see there is a straight line, and it is deviation of a straight line, and it is a transition zone and reaching up to here. So this is what, this is pressure versus drawdown time. One is the pressure versus pressure versus time, and this is a derivative. Derivative means the del P, your P dot. Okay, this is del P, and I'm sorry, P star, first derivative. Okay, so what is happening if you see, this is a normal pressure. Okay, this is pressure, and this is PSI. So you can understand how it is happening. This initially, what is this straight line graph means? You are clearing a stock or maybe tank, so that's why straight line. When it is deviating, that means we have two effect. Your compressible zone has moved from your wellbore to the sand face. That means the reservoir is now little bit supporting. Okay, so here you can see here. So initially it is cleaning the wellbore. Now the sand face is supporting, but due to the restriction, you are getting the graph like this. So initial high, then come low. So this is what, this is the derivative plot. Derivative plot means, I will come to that in detail, why initially it is a positive slope, then in the last part is a negative slope. Okay. And then it is, you see this infinitely acting domain is a straight line. Why it is straight line? And if you come here, is the slope is zero. Okay. So that mathematics and things we'll understand afterwards. But what is my intention here? By analyzing the pressure versus time, we could gauge the physical nature of the area around our well and up to the boundary. Okay, so now if you see here at the end, we are getting a boundary effect. Boundary effect means you are getting here, it is going down, means we are getting much more support. If it is following the same straight line of zero slope in the derivative curve, that means we have the constant support. And if it is going up, that means we don't have any support. Okay. So that means by different way, we try to gather our information to understand the wellbore and wellbore surrounding. Okay. So now is a different procedures actually. One is build-up test. What is build-up test? Build-up test is nothing. A well which is already flowing is set in, and the downhole pressure measured as the pressure builds up here. So it was flowing well up to the initial part. The flow period is a rate of Q. Then we close here. The well flowing rate is now zero. So pressure will initially build up, and then it will follow and go to a stable position. So this is called the build-up. So we'll go into detail afterward, but what is build-up? Build-up is a flowing well is closed and allow it to build the pressure. And each and every point, because once we close it, the pressure pulses will move out from the well to the far away. And depending on the time we are building up, we can even measure the, you can reach up to the initial pressure depending on the situation of the well. Okay. So how to do the test? Pressure recorder is lower down. The physical part we have discussed in the last class, last two classes actually. Pressure recorder is lowered to the bottom of the flowing well. The well is closed for build-up duration. How long you wanted to do for 10